Hey guys, so welcome back to your next class of catalyst concepts. So we have looked at all the process that is involved in getting a pure metal out of the ore that we find inside the earth. So today we'll look at a couple of different terms and different methods that are common when a metallurgy is concerned. So we'll talk about, first we'll talk about two processes that we've already studied about, okay? So if you remember, when we spoke of having your mid-reactive metals, say sulfide ores, we said that if there's a sulfide ore, the first thing that we do is change it into an oxide ore, right? So like for example, if you have something like zinc sulfide, you wanted to change it to zinc oxide, right? And the process for doing this was basically, we blast it with a lot of air and then we just heat it, right? So if I provide oxygen to this, then I'll be left with nothing but zinc oxide and my sulfur just leaves a sulfur dioxide, right? So this was a process that we have seen. If I balance it, it should look something like this, right? So, all right, so this process wherein you use a lot of air to reduce one, let's say one ore into another form of sulfide and oxide, this is called as roasting, okay? So roasting is a process wherein we're using a lot of air and a lot of heat, excess air we call it, excess air and heat to change a sulfide into an oxide, okay? Now, there was another process that was similar to this roasting that we saw, right? When we have something like, let's say a carbonate, let's say magnesium carbonate, okay? I want to change this carbonate into an oxide, okay? So if I have to change a carbonate to an oxide, what I will do is I'm going to try to break this down, right? I'm basically going to try to make a dissociation reaction. So if I have to do that, I'm going to heat this, but in a lack of air, okay? So when you roast, you say excess air and heat, but sometimes you might need to heat it with a lack of air. So in that sense, what it would be is I'll get magnesium oxide and carbon dioxide gas, right? This process is called as calcination. Okay, this process is called calcination, wherein we do heating with a lack of air, and we generally try to dissociate and carbonate into an oxide, or like maybe even if you have a sulfate, you can change it to an oxide. Okay, two processes that we can we just know the names for now that we've already seen the reactions. Now, apart from these two interactions, we've also seen a lot of places where we say we use molten metal, or we kind of melt it, right? So there is one process that we will talk about when it comes to melting, and the name rhymes with melting. It is called as smelting. Okay. So smelting is a process wherein we try to make a solid metal into like a molten liquid state. And as we know, metals have a lot of tolerance for heat. They can absorb heat and they can stay in solid state. It means it takes a lot of temperature for us to melt it. However, it can still be done. And for doing that, we use something called a blast furnace. Okay, so here I'm showing you an image of a blast furnace. And this is what it looks like from the outside. And this is basically a diagram to show how it works. Right? So basically what happens, this skip car is going to add two things from the top. It's going to add the fuel and it's going to add the ore both at the same time through these charge hoppers, right? Now, since both of these are added together, they'll be forming layers of your ore and your fuel. Your fuel is generally coke, which is nothing but a form of coal, and your ore could be iron. So iron is a common thing we use in blast furnaces. Now, once you provide a lot of heat to this, the coal is going to start burning and the heat that is, you know, generated inside is going to melt the metal. Once that happens, at all the way at the bottom, you're going to find two things that will be created. There'll be your molten metal and there's going to be something called as slag. We'll go through the processes over here. Just to go by the flow of the diagram, once the metal and the slag is created, we just separate them from the layers. Slag is something that kind of floats. Okay, so to talk about the process that occurs in this melting is, so primarily you first have, we said, coke, right? Coke is nothing but coal, like we said. If it is burned with oxygen, it provides, it creates something called carbon monoxide gas, right? And a lot of heat too along with it. Now, along with this, what happens? This is nothing but our fuel, okay? Now, once our fuel is combusted, we are adding the iron. So let's talk about iron as in iron ore, let's say hematite ore. So Fe2O3. Okay. Now this will combine with carbon monoxide, which we know is a reducing agent. It is going to reduce that, meaning it will extract the oxygen out of this iron. So what I'll be left with now over here is basically my iron plus 3CO2, right? So basically that carbon monoxide becomes carbon dioxide and it escapes out of the chimney of that furnace. Now we have this iron molten metal, but the problem is since there are other impurities that are added with it, there is going to be some form of impurity, like either be sand or grit or anything it could be. We need, those are also getting melted and are mixed with the iron. We need to separate those out. Okay. So generally whatever impurity is formed, we call it as gange. Okay. So this is our ore, this is our fuel. When we have a certain gang, we try to get it to react with something. Okay. So that something is called as flux. Okay. This flux, for example, let's say is calcium carbonate. Okay. Calcium carbonate, we know. You heard of it, right? So this is one common flux that is used when it comes to iron ore processing. And why, we'll see. So this calcium carbonate will form calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide gas. Okay, this carbon dioxide gas is going to anyway leave. This calcium oxide is what we are going to be working, we are going to be needing. Okay, so this calcium oxide is going to go and interact with this actual that impurity that we're talking about and what we call as slag. Okay, so now this impurity, what it will do is, is going to interact in a way that, let's carry this CaO, calcium oxide plus, let's talk about SiO2. Okay, this is one impurity that you can get from soil. And let me call it gange. Okay, now this gange, once it interacts with this calcium oxide, it will form calcium silicate, CaSiO3. Okay. Now this over here is exactly what is the slag. Okay. So this gange gets converted to slag with the help of flux. This slag becomes easy to remove because it separates out from your metal. Okay. So once at the bottom of your furnace, both of them have gathered, you just separate the slag from the top and the ore from the molten metal from the bottom, just like in the diagram. The slag comes out from your molten iron from here. Right. So this is the whole process that goes inside of a blast furnace. Now, apart from blast furnace, there are other types of furnaces also that are available. Okay. And depending on which process, you can even change the kind of flux that you use. Okay. So calcium carbonate is what we call as a basic flux. Okay. It is basic in nature. Whenever you have an acidic Ganges, you use a basic flux. Okay. Acidic Ganges needs a basic flux, kind of basic chemistry, right? Basic flux. And the vice versa. If there's a basic Ganges, you will use an acidic flux. If you have silica dioxide, SiO2, you could actually use it as a flux also in case you have a basic Ganges. Okay. So this is all about these blast furnace, this melting. Now, when it comes to this blast furnace, the hearth and the firebox are in the same place. So you mix your fuel and your ore together and burn them together. But that is only in blast furnace. In a different furnace, there'll be a different type of arrangement. Like for example, if you look at this reverberative furnace, if you see the firebox is put over here and the heat passes over the ore that's put on the hearth. Okay, so over here the hearth and firebox are separate, but the heat does still reach the ore. It could be the flame, it could also be just the heat of the gases that are escaping. Okay, so I shift from this to a more detailed diagram that I found here, right? So this is your fuel burning, touching the ore, doing the process of the heating process, and the gases escaping from there. We generally use this when you don't want the metal to melt. Okay, so this will help you heat the ore until a before its melting point. So when you do not want it, the metal to melt like in a blast furnace, you will use this process or use this furnace. So this is the major difference between what is a reverberative and what is a blast furnace. Okay, one more thing I'll tell you. These gases that escape out, they're called as flue, F-L-U-E. Okay, so out of the chimney, we have the F-L-U-E, the flue gases that are escaping. Okay, so that's it about reverberatory furnace. You also have another type of furnace, which is not exactly, you don't have a diagram for it, but in that your heat source and your ore will not even touch. Right, so that's it for today. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below. I think this is your last topic, so you will be having your final assessment in the next class. Then just prepare for it, and I'll see you guys in the next lesson. All right, then, thank you so much.